Kat and Eva, and thank you so much for tuning in to Holo Holo, your top entertainment and lifestyle show for and about our APA community. Today, meet the founder of Vanity and Trade, Deborah Chen. Her online publication does trade secrets, how-to blogs, and helps empower and inspire women. Today, we hear her story and gives us a couple of tips on how to succeed. Welcome, Deborah.
Thank you, Kat, for having me on the program.
Thank you for being here. Now, before we get started, I hear that you've majored in finance and
yes.
started in the executive world or corporate world at JP Morgan, was it?
JP Morgan and Lehman Brothers.
And Lehman Brothers. Yes. How was that experience like?
Sure. So I started my career in Wall Street and, as you said, on the trading floors of JP Morgan and Lehman Brothers. So I was cutting my teeth in a very predominantly male industry. So some people call it like a boys club. So I do have like a story or two or three on what goes on behind the scenes of such a fast paced, lucrative world of investing.
Mm-hmm.
And so from there, I then went on to found an international strategic communications firm where I was working with publicly traded companies and CEOs as well as investors and bring a lot of companies in South Korea and China into the United States. So I like to refer to that period as one where it was a time in my life where there was a lot of drinking, a lot of secondhand smoking, and a lot of karaoke bars. But since then, I've, you know, the last 2.5 years, I've kind of taken a step back, got married, had a baby, and then launched Vanity and Trade.
Yes.
So it was kind of a progression there.
Right. How did you, or what inspired you to create Vanity and Trade?
So what really inspired me to launch Vanity and Trade was that, you know, there's so much talk on the whole female empowerment movement. And when you really take a dig into it and you dig a little deeper, you kind of see that there's very little resources and tools to engage with one another through collaboration and mentorship. And so when I, you know, in speaking with so many women out there, recognized that there was definitely a void there, and I wanted to start a platform that really allowed a dialogue between women. And so the format of the website is threefold. I write about my personal experiences, and then I do influencer interviews with people on the Forbes list, thought leaders ranging from political figures to women in tech, science, entertainment. And then I do collaboration features with industry experts on how-to tutorials.
I love that. So it's the trade secrets, it's spotlighting others that are being successful. Now, how do you come up with your blog topics?
So that's a really good question. I think it's really important to do a lot of research to see what's trending. And then I also have a network of people that I go to, my mentors, my family, my friends, and talk about, you know, what are the issues right now that really mean something to you? What's important to you? And then I kind of flesh out and try to find different angles for that.
Do you see a trend right now, or what's some of the trends that you see right now that people are really concerned with?
Sure. Well, that's, you know, that's really interesting because I feel like a couple years ago, everybody was talking about the work and life balance. And I think that's still really hovering over us right now. But I see more and more about how do we have a call to action? And how is it that, you know, we keep talking about this topic, but how do we actually do something about it? And if you look at how many conferences there are with the whole female empowerment movement, that's exactly what they're talking about, you know? So one thing in particular, a theme that's been reoccurring is, do women actually really want to help one another?
Do they? Have you noticed?
You know, I talk to a lot of women from the Forbes list, and it's, you know, there's a lot more collaboration and mentorship nowadays than ever before.
That's great.
But before that, if you think about it, women take so long to climb up the corporate ladder. By the time they get there, there's so many wounds and battle scars, and they think, why would I want to give that away to somebody else for free? Or
I had to deal with all of these challenges.
Exactly.
why am I helping somebody else out? But hopefully that's changing, right? Especially with like the publication that you have, you're definitely turning that around.
Absolutely. There's a lot of evolution there. Mm-hmm. We as people in general, you know, not just women, but men, I think we've all been evolving. Where in the workforce now, it's a lot more about collaboration. So I see that happening.
Yeah, working as a team. And it's not just, your site isn't just for career-minded women. It's also, you know, mothers. It's for people that want to start their own business, right? It's for everyone.
Absolutely. It's an online publication for female entrepreneurs and executives.
Okay, and then I noticed you mentioned mentors. You have a group of mentors. You think that's important for everybody to have? And how do you find mentors?
That's a really, really good question. And that's something that, you know, when I first went out to start this platform, I didn't have really any mentors. I had friends that I bounced off ideas with, but it was something that I felt there were a lot of challenges in going out, because it's hard to just call someone up and say, hey, I love what you do. Can you please mentor me?
It's like the people that say networking is so important. So you go to these events and it's like, well, then what do? Do you just go up to this person and say, hey, I'm so-and-so, will you network? Like, what are the steps? What are the tips?
Without looking kind of creepy and desperate.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now, going to tips, I mentioned earlier, you're going to give us maybe three tips for any woman to succeed. What are your tips?
Sure. Well, you know, so I'm in the process now of really studying the behavior and traits of successful people.
Right.
And so when you look at the commonality and this recurring theme in the women that are movers and shakers in the industry, and they're really like killing it, you know, at their jobs.
Yeah.
I have to say that I see a couple traits, and this is on a very general basis.
Okay.
So I see the first one is having a very clear vision.
Right.
And the second part is being extremely obsessive, seeing nothing else except the finish line. And I would think the third one is the ability to be a little bit foolish.
Okay. Not be afraid to make mistakes or...
Exactly. Yeah. Being a little foolish in a very admirable way, you know, that I find admirable, because you really, really believe in something where no matter what anybody tells you, you're able to kind of be, you know, laser focused.
Right.
And then I think having the ability to bounce back from failures.
Right.
And I speak with a lot of investors who say that they don't want to invest in anyone unless they've failed multiple times.
Oh, wow.
And so when you put that in perspective, you think that so many people are so afraid of failure,
right,
when you can actually have that as an asset when done correctly.
Yeah. And you can learn from your failures, hopefully.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much, Deborah. Wonderful tips. There's more on your website, right? What's your website?
The website is vanityandtrade.com. Uh-huh. Check it out. And you can follow me at vanityandtrade at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Thank you. A pleasure having you here today.
Thank you for having me.
Sharing your story. Again, for more information on Deborah and Vanity and Trade, to get the how-tos and the tips on being successful, be sure to check out her website. The information is on your screen. We'll be back.